वेलकम टू दिस थर्ड लेक्चर। वंस अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद द रिमेनिंग बैकग्राउंड एंड एट प्रेजेंट वी आर डिस्कसिंग योर 20th सेंचुरी सोशल बैकग्राउंड। सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू रिज्यूम अवर लेक्चर फ्रॉम the fifth point. So in previous lecture we discussed initial four important features of the century. Now rest of the points we are going to discuss now. So this is yet to be discussed in detail. In last lecture we did not complete this point, revolt against authority. So the word revolt is really loaded. It is very 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 suggestive, and generally revolt against that thing is being undertaken. So if the thing is not tolerable, if there is something that is not acceptable, even there is something that is against our principles, or if there is something that doesn't suit us. So basically revolt is against such things, and I am especially concerned about revolt in certain areas. For example, again and again 19th century Victorian morality is again and again targeted by the 20th century people. Because whatever that was acceptable in the past, it may not be acceptable at present. So whatever that was moral in the past, it may not be moral nowadays. So in this way, there are a variety of issues against which the 20th century people raise the badge of revolt. Badge means indication, something that is being shown. So I am more concerned about certain things. Especially I talked about Victorian morality. Generally Victorian morality was viewed from the perspective of people's sexual behavior. So many a time our morality is being mixed with our overall sexual way of life, and because of this particular a sort of association between morality and sexual behavior, so many restrictions were being laid by the Victorian society. I am more concerned about British society because this is somewhat British history that we are going to we are discussing, because this overall gamut of this background is of, or it is from British history, because all the literary pieces that we are about to begin studying or we are about to discuss. So all those literary pieces are written by the writers from Great Britain. So therefore we have to restrict this background to more particularly to British history. So, and because of so many restrictions, so the 19th century people were completely fed up. And if there is something that is beyond tolerance, So generally people throw away the thing that is not tolerable. Similar things happened with the 19th century. So whatever it was not considered to be good, whatever it was not considered to be positive, so all those things were being discarded by the 20th century society. So if you think about the overall nature of 20th century fashion, overall nature of 20th century warfare, even overall nature of 20th century literature, even if you think about the kind of literary criticism which existed in 19th century, so all these old things were being disregarded by the 20th century people. So therefore, so this is the revolt against authority that took place in 20th century. And I am more particularly talking about the condition of the world before the end of the Second World War, before 1945. So the world before 1945, it was altogether different than the world which came forward after the end of the Second World War. It was completely different world. It was the postmodern world. So, and even modern age and even the postmodern age always raise the banner of revolt. If you think about the kind of poetry which is written by a person, a poet like T.S. Eliot, it is nothing but it's a revolt. For example, if you think about his poem, The Wasteland, initially it was criticized in a very harsh manner, but later the poem The Wasteland, which was published in the year 1922, this poem was completely hailed globally later. Initially it was being criticized. Okay. Because that poem accepted a new form. That poem used so many languages in it. So initially such a matter was not acceptable for the conventional or you can say conservative sort of people, but later it became acceptable everywhere. So we know that. So 20th century people revolted against the authority. So this is the fifth point. The sixth point: collapse of old values and ideals. In Marathi, values means mulya. So there are certain values that are important in our daily affairs, in our day-to-day life. For example, in India, Gandhism is a value. So the thoughts which were very dear to Dr. Ambedkar, so those thoughts have become values nowadays. To take the side of Dalits or to take the side of the oppressed people, so it has become value nowadays. So if you think about the 20th century, so this 20th century witnessed collapse. So collapse means kosun padne. Okay. So the values which were very dear to the Victorian England, those values were completely rejected by the 20th century people. So this is something that is given in this context. So people's way of behavior was different in 19th century. So that way of behavior, it was not accepted for the 20th century people. So it's a great gap between the olden period of 19th century and the modern period and postmodern period of the 20th century. So there had been so many old things which badly collapsed. And among them were values and ideals. Ideals means adarsh. जुन्या काळामध्ये जी काही म्हणजे मूल्यांची व्यवस्था होती, जुन्या काळामध्ये जे काही म्हणजे आदर्श वगैरे होते, त्या सगळ्याच्या सगळ्या आदर्शांना म्हणजे काय खरं तर या काळामध्ये म्हणजे काय म्हणजे त्या सगळ्याच्या सगळ्या आदर्शांना म्हणजे या काळामध्ये बिलकुल म्हणजे महत्व नव्हतं. बिकॉज ऑल दोज आयडियाज अँड व्हॅल्यूज कम्प्लिटली क्रम्बल्ड, दे कम्प्लिटली कोलॅप्स्ड. And even a value is something that we call to be ideal, or the value is something we try to live our life with the help of those values. And generally, it is believed that if our values are good, definitely we will be able to make ourselves progressive and forward looking. But the 20th century period was such a period during which the old values completely fell down, and there had been new accepted values in the 20th century, and those values have been given a lot of space in many literary pieces of the century, last century, 20th century. So comparatively, if you compare between previous century and the present century, so comparatively 20th century witnessed drastic changes in all the walks of human life, and those drastic changes occurred due to certain reasons, and one of the very important reasons was the First as well as the Second World War. And generally during such disasters, I should say, because wars are generally, world wars were definitely disasters, it was a great challenge for the overall existence of the mankind, and even you can say other kinds. And whatever values existed in the past, those values were thrown away, and new values were incorporated. And actually this happened in a very robust manner, speedy manner. And generally these two world wars are believed to be the driving forces of so many changes, not only for values and ideas, but these two wars, world wars, First as well as the Second World War, completely altered the overall nature of our existence. It completely altered the overall being of this planet. Okay. So, and if everything is altered, then what is the importance of values for certain people, values and ideals, even those who are completely altered? So in olden days, women were completely relegated to certain activities of, you can say, for example, cooking was the principal task which was being completely assigned to women in the past. But due to the advent of feminism, so more or less women were liberated due to that movement. So women empowerment came forward in a very powerful manner, and it was a new value to treat women equally. It was not a value in the past, and one should not shed tears by saying that whatever old was there, it was good. Many a time old things are not that much good. For instance, if you think about the situation in India before our independence, so it was the situation of lot of casteism. So Dalits were not given any importance, but a person, a great person like Dr. Ambedkar, came forward, and in this way he started the movement of liberating these lower classes, lower masses, and to take care of common people, those so called untouchables, to think about the welfare of these so-called untouchables, and nowadays there is a term called Dalits. So it became a value later. Non-violence became a value because of Mahatma Gandhi's great work in India and abroad. So in this way, old values collapse, new values come in the mainstream, and in this way, so this is the cyclical nature of our existence, and this cyclical nature of our existence became more speedy, or it became changing more speedily during the 20th century. So old values, they were deserted, they were left behind. New values were accepted in our way of life, and in this way, so comparatively, if you compare 20th century with the previous centuries, comparatively, this 20th century witnessed the collapse of old values and ideals, and because of the two world wars, as I said, and because of so many movements causing enlightenment across the world. So this is something that one has to keep in mind. So I hope I am giving appropriate details about these points. Seventh point is search for novelty. Novelty means navinya. And this novelty is not something, for example, if you try to make something new, it is not like that. So, this novelty was in terms of the overall way of being, the overall way of existence of the mankind. So, there have been so many newer things which were given a lot of speed in the 20th century. Not only in the field of science and technology, but even in the field of art, Karikrishatra Madhe I am talking about. So, lot of search for novelty became so prominent during the 20th century. In the field of art, as I said, for example, painting is an art. In the field of painting, lot of novel things, lot of new things were being included by so many great painters. For instance, the paintings of great Italian painter Picasso. So he always wanted to make something new. Even if you think about so many paintings by M.F. Hussain, our very own M.F. Hussain. So these people incorporated so many new things in their expressions. So I was talking about Picasso, Pablo Picasso. So many a time his combinations in the painting seemed to be quite strange. So he was searching for novelty. I always give this example. So just for the sake of an instance, just imagine that if Picasso is painting a picture of a road accident, and there had been a very deadly road accident over there, and he is sketching on his painting on the basis of that accident. So he will use many colors in that painting, and if one of the tires is separated from that vehicle, maybe car or something, so he will bring actual piece of that car tire, and he will put that piece in his painting. This is something new. So, this is only for the sake of example. A great poet like T.S. Eliot did lot of experimentation, prayog. For example, he did so many experiments in his poem, which I mentioned in the last lecture, The Westland. So, lot of experimentation is done by T.S. Eliot. For example, he has, even in this lecture I refer to it, he used so many languages including Sanskrit. So, lot of experimentation he did in that poem. It was the search for something new that T.S. Eliot has used in his literary pieces. So this is only for the sake of examples. For instance, lot of novelty was found in the art called dancing, painting. So whatever form of art you take into consideration, so lot of novelty people wanted to discover, people wanted to intuit. So this is search for novelty that was accepted or it was being seriously considered by the 20th century people, especially artists. So this is search for novelty. And the last characteristic or feature of this social background is moral complexities. Even we discussed these complications in this fourth characteristics, changing patterns of relationships. So morally, the 20th century is considered to be very, very complicated era, morally. So, what is mean by morality? This is a moot question. So, actually, it is believed that morality tries to bind our overall behavior. For example, a typical Maharashtrian rural person will always take into consideration certain things when that person is living. So many a time people think about pap and punya. So righteousness is something which can be equated with punya, and something that is sinful. Okay, so generally people always say that if I do this, whether it will be righteous or whether it will be a kind of sin. So many a time, so these are the moral things that we are associated with many a time. So comparatively, 20th century witnessed more complications in terms of morality. Victorian morality, 19th century morality was a different thing, and 20th century morality was different because 20th century Western people never wanted to include people's sexual behavior in morality. Actually, we do include our sexual behavior in morality in a country like India. So this is the last feature. Moral complications were rampant. So, if you think about from Indian perspective, if you think about the kind of relationship that is being shown by D.H. Lawrence in his novels, Sons and Lovers, then Rainbow, then White Peacock, Women in Love, okay, Aaron's Rod, Kangaroo, if you think about all these novels by D.H. Lawrence, so from Indian perspective, all those novels include lot of moral complexities. So, the kind of complicated relations that people have, and these relationships are being equated with moral behavior. So, while I discuss literary background, even I am going to talk about that. So, there is a concept called Oedipus complex. It's a sort of emotional entanglement between mother and her male child, son. D.H. Lawrence has discussed this Oedipus complex in a very wide manner in his novels that I just mentioned. And from the perspective of Indians, those novels are nothing but they are the amalgamations of moral complexities. It's a mixture of moral complications, people believe. Indian people believe. And even there are some instances of Electra complex, complicated, or you can say this, a sort of possessive relationship between the father and his daughter. Rainbow is the best example by D.H. Lawrence himself. So there are so many moral complexities that are found in the 20th century, and generally all these moral complexities are truly reflected in many literary pieces. There is T.S. Eliot, as I mentioned. There is D.H. Lawrence. Even there is very important post-modern novelist, namely William Golding. So, a variety of complications are being dealt with. And among them is moral complexities. So, in the last two lectures, we have discussed all these eight important characteristics or features of the 20th century social background. And in the next lecture, we are going to talk about 20th century literary background. So this is sufficient regarding 20th century social background. So thank you very much. In the next lecture, we are going to associate ourselves with the literary background of the last century, 20th century. Thank you very much. Thank you.